There's a lot of different pre-workouts out there. This is my pre-workout of choice. Black coffee, baby. I am now 3 weeks, as of yesterday, past my hernia surgery, and the doctor said each week I can add a little more weight. And so, like, literally the max I'm going on anything is 65 pounds, because you can't strain your abs too much. That's where the hernia is. And so today is a little bit of a total body workout, but this, again, this is the heaviest I'll go. They say it takes 4 weeks to recover, so next Thursday I'll be able to start adding more weight. The doctor said I should be back to normal. Now, obviously, I won't be able to go full force, but at least I get to start adding some weight, so that'll be nice. That you'll be here when I need you the most, so don't let me, don't let me, don't let me down. About to go for my daily walk. Look at the sun. Look at this. This is super foggy. See that little dot right there? That's the sun. But anyway, so as of yesterday, it's been 3 weeks since my hernia surgery, and I was told that full recovery would take about 4 weeks. So I'm making this video for anyone out there who may be going through the same thing, because I know when I was going through it at the beginning, I was trying to find out what to expect. Some things to do to take care of myself. And so first and foremost, obviously you want to listen to your doctor. So do whatever they tell you. They told me 4 weeks. They said don't pick up any more than 30 pounds in the beginning, and then you can slowly start to add. And so for the first week, I was really able to do hardly anything. It hurt to even stand straight up. I had what's called an umbilical hernia, so it was like right above my belly button. And it hurt to stand upright because you had to stretch that out. So night one, they didn't tell me this, and apparently this is common, so just to help you out. It's common when you have surgery for gas buildup in your body, and it's very painful. And I didn't know about it until the day after when we called and were like, hey, what's going on? And so what I recommend is before your surgery, get some Gas X. I know it sounds funny. Get some Gas X, get some like Zevia or some soda. I can add a sugar-free soda to help with you burp and stuff, and all that will help. And so as soon as I started doing that, all that pain went away. And so the first 3 or 4 days, I was pretty much bedridden or couch-ridden. I couldn't really move a whole lot. It hurt just to walk to the bathroom for the first 3 or 4 days. After that, things slowly started getting better. And after about 1 week, I was able to incorporate some very, 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 can't emphasize that enough, light body weight movements, maybe some squats, some push-ups, depending on how it was feeling. So obviously you want to be careful, listen to your body. And then I could start to walk a little bit. So that was after week one. After week two, I started adding very little weight. So for instance, I think like 20 pounds was the heaviest I went after week two, and I felt like I could do more, but I didn't want to push it because obviously I don't want to go through that again. And so 20 pounds, and then after about week three, so this is week three now, on week three I started adding more weight. I'm up to like 65, I think, is the heaviest I've gone, and that's on bench press, so that's way less than what I would normally do. But I'm listening to my body, I'm listening to the doctor. And so this is 3 weeks out now, and I'm able to do a little bit more. I've been walking a lot. Like, there's really no pain now. If I stretch too far, or if I, like, you know, I'm rotating, grabbing something or whatever, I can feel it, but it's not painful. I can just feel that there's tension there. Other than that, it's been pretty good. So this is week three. They said 4 weeks till full recovery, and so we'll see how we feel, how I feel in a week from now. But as of now, every day is getting a little bit easier, and so that's kind of what I went through. Like I said, listen to your doctor, do whatever they tell you to do, obviously. And every hernia is different. I had, like I said, an umbilical hernia. I know people that have different types that are a little more painful, so obviously you want to do what the doctor says. But 1 week from now, hopefully I'll be adding some more weight. Obviously not as much as I used to. I have to work my way up to that. But that's where I stand, week three after hernia surgery. One thing that I probably should mention is obviously when you're not able to move as much, I had to watch what I was eating a lot more. The first few days was no problem because I really didn't have much of an appetite. But as I got that appetite back, I started watching my carbs, because before the hernia, I was bulking. I was doing heavy squats, heavy bench, heavy deadlifts, overhead press, all that. And I was eating like 3 to 350 grams of carbs a day. And so once I was told before the surgery to take it easy, I knocked that down to closer to 200, because I was still lifting weights, but it was just light. And then once the surgery hit and once I got my appetite back, I'm like at 150, 175 grams of carbs a day, because now I'm incorporating some activity back into my routine. Over the past couple weeks, I've lost pretty close to 10 pounds just watching my carbs, going for daily walks, which I'm about to do, and incorporating some more activity. So that's one thing that's helped keep me disciplined, is just tracking my food, making sure I'm not overeating, because when you can't move a whole lot, obviously it's going to store as fat. And so, yep, that's what I've been doing.